This is Python Pop, a series of quick videos explaining different Python functions and commands. And today what I want to do is go over the dot product. And we're going to do two different methods in order to get the same exact result. One of those methods is going to be a for loop, and another one's going to be even simpler. So let's start by defining two different vectors. So I'm going to say sum vector A, and I'll keep this in a list format. So we're going to give the values I, J, K, or if you want to think of it as X, Y, and Z, as 2, 4, and then 3. And then we'll have sum vector B. Sum list B is going to be 6, 5, and then 1. Now, remember, the dot product, you multiply the I components together, then you multiply the J components, then the K, and then you sum that all up. So the result of the dot product is a scalar. So we're going to get a single value for this. And let's set our dot product to be some value. Initially, let's make that 0. So now I'm going to set up a for loop that loops through each value in list A and multiplies it by the corresponding value in list B and then sums it together. So we're going to say for I, so we'll get an index value in range of the length of list A. What I want to do is I want to multiply A sub I by B sub I. So when I is 0, that will be 2 times 6. When I is 1, that'll be 4 times 5, and so on. And let's store that as a value. So value is going to equal A of I times B of I. And then what do we want to do with that value? Ultimately, in the end, we're going to sum up each of those individual values we get. And we can do that right on in our for loop by setting the dot product equal to itself plus value. So you can say dot product equals dot product plus value, or shorthand will be plus equals value. And then let's go ahead and print out that dot product. So, doing a quick double check, in our heads, before we even run this code, let's evaluate the dot product. 2 times 6 is 12, 4 times 5 is 20, 3 times 1 is 3, so 12 plus 20 plus 3 should equal 35, and when we run this, we do indeed get 35. But what if I told you there was a simpler way by using a package? So we're going to import NumPy as np, make sure I have that installed correctly, and now it's as simple as np dot dot, and then we're going to type in our two separate lists, which are representative of vectors. And there we got it, 35. So two separate ways. Go ahead and time each of these and see which one runs faster. As you become more advanced at coding, time is of the essence. There we have it, two different methods for the dot product that give you the same exact result. And that wraps up this video. As always, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.